Hi, this is Anil from Learning Lad Education, and welcome to another tutorial on Java programming language. In the previous tutorials, we have learned about the methods in Java, and also I have taught you guys in how exactly we can pass parameters to the methods. And here in this tutorial, we're gonna learn how exactly we can pass an array to a method, and also how exactly we can return an array from a method. So just for the demonstration purpose, in this tutorial, what we're gonna do is inside my main method, I'm gonna create an array. So I'm just gonna create an integer array, and let me call it as marks. And inside this array, I'm gonna store some integer values, and let's say 22, 66, 33, 99, 88, 77. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna create a method, and we're gonna pass this marks array as the argument to that method. So after this main method, inside my tutorial class, I'm gonna create a method. So first we need to write the modifiers. So it's gonna be public, static, and after this modifier part, we need to write the return type. Here I'm gonna assume that my method is gonna return void type, which it means no return values. So I'm just gonna use void, and then we're gonna write the method name. The method that I'm gonna create here is gonna take an integer array as a parameter, and it's gonna display the elements of that array. So I'm just gonna call this method as display, and then a pair of parentheses, and then a pair of curly braces. Now between these parentheses, we need to specify the parameters taken by this display method. Here our method is gonna take an integer array, so I have to declare an integer array here. So I'm just gonna use the data type as int, then a pair of square brackets, and then I just need to give a name for the integer array. So I'm just gonna call it as input. Now our display method is not gonna return any value, and it's gonna take an integer array as a parameter. So inside this display method, we're gonna display the elements of this input array. So I'm gonna use a for loop. So it's gonna be for, and we're gonna need a loop counter variable, and I'm gonna declare that right here, and I'm gonna initialize that one to 0, and then we need to write the condition part. So it's gonna be counter less than, we need to loop through all the elements of this input array. So we can get the length of this input array by using the length property. So it's gonna be input, the array name, dot operator, and then the length, and then we're gonna have the semicolon, and we need to increment the value of the counter variable. And after that, we're just gonna use a println method. So it's gonna be system.out.println, and here we're gonna refer the input array, and we're gonna refer the element position by using the counter variable's value. So this display method now is gonna take an array as a parameter, an integer array as a parameter, and it's gonna display the elements of that integer array. So now we're gonna call this display method from our main method. So here I'm gonna write display, the method name, and then I have to pass this marks array. So I'm just gonna write marks here as an argument, and I'm gonna save this program, and I'm gonna run this. And now you guys can see here the elements of that array: 22, 66, 33, 99, 88, and 77 are successfully passed to this display method, and we have successfully printed the element of the passed array. So this is how you guys can pass a single dimensional array to a method. The next thing that I want you guys to teach you is how exactly we can return an array from a method. So here in my tutorials class, I'm gonna define another method which is gonna take an integer array as a parameter, and also it's gonna return an integer array. The method that I'm gonna create is gonna take an integer array, and it's gonna create another array with reversed element of the passed array, and it's gonna return that reversed array. So we're gonna write the modifier part. So it's gonna be public, and then we're gonna have the static keyword, and after that we need to write the return type. Here, our method is gonna return an integer array. All of you know that if you want to return an integer value from a method, you guys need to use the keyword int. Here, in this case, we are returning an integer array. So we're gonna use the square brackets to specify that we are talking about arrays here. And then we just need to give a name for our method. And here our method is gonna reverse the array element. So I'm just gonna say reverse array. And then we need to have a pair of parentheses and then a pair of curly braces. Now, as a parameter to this reverse array, we're gonna pass an integer array. So all of you know how you can do that. Just now I have taught you about that. So it's gonna be int, and I'm gonna call this array as input. All right. Now, what we're gonna do is we're gonna create another array inside this reverse array method, because we don't want to reverse the element in this input array. We want to reverse the element and then we want to store it in another array and we want to return that array. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna create an integer array. So our array is gonna be of type integers. So I'm gonna declare it. So it's gonna be here int, then the array name, I'm gonna say reverse, and then we're gonna write new, you know, the new keyword to create an array. And then we're gonna have the data type, which is gonna be int. And now here between these square brackets, we need to specify the length for this reverse array. Now this reverse array is gonna contain the element of this input array in reverse order. So the length of this reverse array is gonna be equal to the length of this input array. And all of you know that we can get the length of this input array by using the length property. So I'm gonna write input here, the array name, and then I'm gonna use the dot operator, and then I'm gonna use the length property. And the next thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna loop through all the element of this input array, and we're gonna store that in reverse order. For that purpose, I'm gonna use a for loop, and inside this for loop, we're gonna use two variables, one for the input array and one for the reverse array. So I'm gonna create a variable called I, and this variable is gonna be for the input array, and that's why I'm gonna initialize that one to a value of 0. And then we're gonna need another variable for this reverse array. And that variable is also gonna be of type integers, and I'm gonna call it as j. Here, we're gonna initialize this j variable with 1 less than the length of this input array. Because in an array, the last element will be stored at the position 1 less than the length of that array. So here, what we're gonna do is, first we're gonna take the first element from the input array, and we're gonna store that in last element of the reverse array. So here I'm gonna use reverse dot length minus 1. So our I is gonna be equal to 0, which begin with the first location of the input array, and this j is gonna contain a value which will indicate the last position of this reverse array. And then we need to write a condition. We want to run this loop until we loop through all the elements. So we're gonna use the condition as I less than input dot length. And then we need to write the updation part. Here we want to increment the value of I. So it's gonna be I plus plus. And then I'm gonna use the comma operator, and we need to decrement the value of j. So it's gonna be j minus minus. So here you guys can see inside this for loop, we are using more than one variable. So here we have separated that using the comma operator in this initialization part, and also in this updation part, you guys can see that in this condition part, we can't use the comma operator. And if you want to form a complex condition, then you have to use the logical operators. But in this case, that's not necessary, because we want to run this loop until we loop through all the elements of this input array. And that's why this one condition using this variable I is enough. And now inside this for loop, what we're gonna do is we're gonna store the elements in this reverse array. So it's gonna be reverse of j equal to input of I. So now after this for loop, this reverse array is gonna contain all the elements of this input array in reverse order. The last thing that we're gonna do is we're gonna return this reverse array. So after this for loop, before the end of this reverse array method, we're gonna return the array. And to return a value, we need to use the return keyword, and here we're gonna specify reverse. That's it. Now our reverse array method is gonna take an integer array as a parameter, and it's gonna reverse that passed array, and it's gonna return a new array with reversed elements. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna call this reverse array method in our main method, and we're gonna pass an array to that. And here now our reverse array method is gonna return an integer array. So to store that, what we're gonna do in this main method is we're gonna create an integer array. So it's gonna be int, then it's gonna be an array. So I'm just gonna declare an array, and I'm gonna call it as remarks. And here make a note that we are not allocating the memory for this remarks. The array returned by this reverse array method will be stored in this remarks variable. So here what we're gonna do is we're gonna write remarks equal to, then we're gonna call this reverse array method. So I'm just gonna copy this and paste it here. And now to this reverse array method, we need to pass an array. So I'm gonna pass this marks array. And after that, what we're gonna do is we're gonna use a println statement just to make our output pretty, you know, to differentiate between this marks array and this reverse array element. So I'm just gonna use the system.out.println method. And I'm gonna say reversed array elements, and then we're gonna call this display method again. So it's gonna be display, and now we're gonna pass this remarks array. So I'm just gonna copy this and I'm gonna paste it here, and then I'm gonna save this and I'm gonna run this program. Now you guys can see this is the array, marks array, which we have printed out using the display method. And then here is the reversed array from our reverse array method. So you guys can clearly see here array elements are been reversed. So 77, 88, 99, 33, 66, and 22. Here in this main method, what we have done is we have declared this remarks to store the return value from this reverse array method. What we can do is we can directly call this display method, and we can pass the return value, you know, return array to this display method directly. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna comment this code, and this one also, and we're gonna comment this one too, so that when you get the source code of this tutorial, you guys can try it out. And here I'm gonna call the display method again, and here what we can do is we're gonna pass the return value from this reverse array method directly to this display method. So I'm gonna copy this and I'm gonna paste it here. And if I save this and run this program, it's gonna work just like the way it was working before. So I'm gonna run this, and you guys can see there is no difference in the previous run. So this is how you guys can pass an array, a single dimensional array, to a method, and also you guys can return a single dimensional array from a method. So thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. You guys can like my Facebook page at facebook.com/learninglad, and also you guys can follow me on Twitter at learningladedu, and also you guys can get the source code of this tutorial in my website learninglad.com, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.